Senator Abetz.
Getup's attempt to rehabilitate its self-besmirched reputation at the National Press Club today failed. Failed badly. Why? Because the facts speak so much better than its empty rhetoric. Rather than apologising for their tactics, Getup foolishly doubled down and sent out the architect of their flawed campaign to try and justify the unjustifiable. The self-serving claim that Getup is, built on ordinary people, taking action on issues they care about is hollow. Did Getup members actually urge Getup to develop and run advertisements that were demonstrably untrue, ugly, nasty, and in such poor taste that Getup was shamed into dropping them? Of course not. Adverts that falsely claimed a person who had saved another person's life would sit idly by and watch someone drown. No, ordinary decent people don't do such things, but Getup did. Or the advertisement against the Treasurer, Josh Frydenberg. Not supporter-initiated, I'm sure. Ordinary, decent people don't seek to so deceive. Who can forget the ugliness, the nastiness, the politics of division and denigration in which Getup wallowed, spending thousands of dollars of their so-called members' money? Shamelessly, the National Press Club was told Getup asks, does the campaign resonate with people's lives each time they run a campaign? Really? Did the false allegations against Mr. Frydenberg really resonate with people's lives? I'd like to see the membership feedback on that one. Or did the campaign against Mr. Dutton so resonate that his margin actually increased? Getup takes the Australian people as mugs to be manipulated. Next, Getup falsely asserted to the National Press Club that the Australian Electoral Commission had confirmed their political independence. Simply false. It's not the role of the AEC to make such a finding, and when I asked the AEC about this claim, they said it was not their role and denied making such a claim. Nevertheless, it didn't stop Getup from saying exactly that at the National Press Club here today. They repeated the falsehood in front of the nation's media, and shamefully did so without any hesitation. To take some political licence is one thing, but a verbal and independent statutory authority confirms there are no boundaries, no codes, no ethics for Getup. For them, their self-determined correctness justifies any course of action. But the deceit doesn't end there. Getup claimed they didn't just campaign against the Liberal Party. Tellingly, no mention was made of any House of Representative other than Liberal against whom they campaigned, because they couldn't. Who could forget in Longman Getup's phone canvassing, asking voters to put the Liberals last, thus preferring a white supremacist and convicted criminal? But yet they claim they don't only campaign against Liberals. Who can forget the campaign against Nicole Flint? Even Labor luminaries are cringing at Getup's tactics and antics, turning off decent Australians. When Getup isn't officially amending its objectives to falsely claim it's a charity, and then, when exposed, says it was an administrative error, Getup claims it has unusual levels of transparency. With this I agree, highly unusual, as is shown by listing all its important decision makers in Schedule 1 of its constitution. However, Schedule 1 remained blank and empty at all times until it was finally taken out of its constitution. So much for transparency. This time round, this election, despite spending literally millions of dollars, the people rejected Getup's tactics of deceit. Having spent millions themselves, they decried others that had spent millions as well. Like Clive Palmer, Getup can spend millions in our democracy on a campaign, but just as much as they were a wake-up to Clive Palmer as a result of 2013, so the Australian people were a wake-up to Getup as a result of 2016, and might I finish by saying exposing GetUp's slipperiness is not about trying to silence opponents or subverting democracy. It's about informing people, and once informed,
Senator
they
Abetz,
reject GetUp.
Your time has